Why doesn't Chabad learn from Sifrei Musar, such as the Ramchal?
I want to begin the answer to this question with a story that I heard 35 years ago. In other words, I heard the story around the time that the story actually occurred. That there was a young man, a Lubavitcher young man, very learned, who, for whatever reasons, began to learn philosophies outside of Hasidus, maybe philosophies outside of Yiddishkeit. And he had a yechidus with the Rebbe. And the way I heard the story then was that Rebbe told him, amongst other things, two things that I heard. Number one, that Rebbe said to him that he has no, a younger man wie dir darf lernen Chassidus a ganzen Tag. A young man like you should spend his entire day learning Chassidus. You shouldn't have time or need for other philosophies. And in addition, that Rebbe told him, Gleib mir, alle Philosophie sind in Veranen in Chassidus. All philosophies are found in Chassidus. I say this because the correct answer to the question is that we don't really learn other Sifrei Musar and Ramchal. From the Rishonim is different, especially the Chavis HaLavovis. We learn Shara Betochen and so on, but we don't really learn other Sifrei Musar, and I'll tell you why. Because learning Sifrei Musar is not about academics, it's not about the collection of knowledge, eclecticism, if you will. It's about life. And one of the most important things in life is to have one derech, not to dabble in different drachim. And the Rabbeim, Chabad Rabbeim, incorporated into Chabad Chassidus everything. Chassidus Chabad has direct quotes, complete pages of the Sifrei Musar from the Rishonim, like the Shari Tshuva and the Archei Tzaddikim, and so on. And of course, from the Sifrei Musar, there are Pikabolis, the Deisim, Baharari Kedish. There are certainly whole sections based on Sifrei Musar from different Sfarim. You also have, in some cases, entire Meir Nevuchims or Rambans quoted. So Chassidus is a synthesis, it's a compilation that the Rabbeim put together from the Torah of all the Gedali Yisrael and all the different Shittas that came before. But it isn't a random hodgepodge of ideas. It's a precise selection of ideas that emerges as the unique derech, which is Chassidus Beklal and Chassidus Chabad in particular. In other words, there are different shittas in Musar. It's not all the same. And different drachim have different hashkafas. To give a simple example, the example of tukfa, the nishmasa, chusha, the gufa, the belief and the idea of sigufim, versus the Baal Shem Tov's teaching of Oziv Taziv Imi, the body has to be healthy. That's a real difference in Sifrei Musar. And Chassidus says it's derech. And a person who learns Chassidus not just because he's curious, and not just because he's an intellectual, because it's teaching him how to serve the Eibishter, you don't split your engagement in a derech chayim, in a way of learning how to live, by dabbling in different svarim. You choose your derech, you have your Rebbe, and you follow his path to the exclusion of all others. And like I said, in Chabad, you have the best of all the other Sfarim, and you can oftentimes see how the Rabbeim collected their ideas from all sources and synthesized them into the Shita of Chabad in such a way that it's consistent with the Derech of the Alter Rebbe and so on. So the first thing that I'm saying is that in Chassidus Chabad you have everything. And the second thing I want to say, and this is very important, in my humble opinion, we're living in the age of eclecticism. Everybody is a nasher. Everybody's trying a little of this and a little of this and a little of this. Included in this nashing is nashing on Chassidus Chabad. And it's very popular to be a pluralist, you know, to be able to quote all kinds of svarim. And of course, the argument is that this is open-mindedness, that this is Shalom v'shalva, this is getting along, and this is peace. And I have to be honest, it bothers me. I would much rather that every community have its derech, and we should argue and disagree, rather than everybody sharing everybody's derech, because this tendency towards everybody dabbling and gnashing means we don't really have an anchor. We have no roots. People want to serve the Eibishter how they want. sort of take a little from here, a little from there. When you take a little from here and a little from there, a little from someplace else, you have nothing. The only way you have a real derech and avedas Hashem, which teaches you constant avodah and helps you ascend from one step to another step, to closer to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, if you have one Rebbe and you have one Shita and you follow that path. I appreciate the beauty of the pluralism because it reduces machlaikis. And certainly as a Lubavitcher Chassid, it's become quite popular today for people outside of Chabad to begin to learn Chabad Chassidus, when 30, 40 years ago it was almost unheard of. But there's a part of me that almost wishes we had the fighting that we had back then, because there was a genuineness to it. Everybody had a shita, had a derech. Chassidus Chabad is not a curiosity. Chassidus Chabad is not something you do because it's interesting. Chassidus Chabad is a way of life. And you can't split yourself. Your way of life can't be divided. It has to be unique and distinct and singular. And yes, a person can have a different derech, but he needs one. Not a little bit of this and a little bit of that. It's really a lot of nothing. And this is the second reason why Chassidus Chabad is so loyal to Chassidus Chabad, because it's not just a Torah, it's an avoida. Or to say it in other words, in as much as it's a Torah, we learn everything. But in terms of derech chaim techachas musar, that pnimiyas ha-Torah, Chassidus Chabad gives us a path, derech oyle beiskel, based on the heroes and the hadrochas of Rabbi Seinu Nisienu. And of course for us this means our Rebbe, our Nasi, the Rebbe, the Nasi of Deir HaShvi, who gave us a very clear but unique and distinct path about how we're supposed to serve HaKadosh Baruch Hu. This is not something that you treat as a course of a meal that has many courses. This is a way of life, and it's very, very singular. I would imagine that not everybody agrees with me, but I believe quite strongly what I'm saying. There's, like I said before, there's a part of me that wishes that every community of Jews would be fighting with all other communities because they are very loyal to their shita rather than it all being farparef. You know, we all get along because we don't care as much about what made us unique and distinct and different. That passion, that singularity is good. Machlaikis isn't good. But dedication to your Rebbe and to your derech is very good and very, very important. I want to finish with a related thought that's controversial. But I want to put it here nevertheless. There was a man named Herbert Weiner who interviewed the Rebbe in the 1950s, and his articles were published in a scholarly journal back then, and he published it later in a book, 9 and a Half Mystics. It's been repeated many times, these articles. And they're very easy to find, by the way. One of the points, he interviewed the Rebbe extensively, and one of the many questions he asked the Rebbe was, what did the Rebbe think of Rabbi Yitzchak Isaac Alevi Cook, the great Harav Cook? What do you think of Rabbi Cook? And the Rebbe told him the following. Rabbi Cook mixed Kabbalah and philosophy and science, and maybe he mentioned a few other things, in teaching his students. And the Rebbe said he confused his students. When you give your students too much variety, they become unclear where the anchor is. And the Rebbe used the expression, a teacher cannot do this to his students. A Rebbe cannot do this to his Talmidim. This is more or less a quote of the Rebbe's response. The Rebbe said to him, Rabbi Cook mixed too many things, philosophy and Kabbalah and science, and it's confusing to his students, and a teacher is not allowed to confuse his students. At kan teichen advarim, and if you could look up the source and see exactly the way it's quoted. But the point of this is, you know, again, we live in the modern age. The modern age is about information and knowledge and curiosity. A Rebbe who teaches people how to serve Hashem is not about knowledge and curiosity. It's about a path. And a Rebbe's primary goal is to create a path that's simple. That's not the same thing as saying simplistic, but simple. The Talmidim, the Hasidim should know exactly what their path is. And when it becomes too complicated, even if it becomes too complicated because it's very intelligent, And the Rebbe doesn't appreciate, like it says in the Mishnah Pirkei Avos, he's zorah b'devreichem, because the Talmidim aboyim acharechem yishtu, because they will not fully understand the eimik kavanas harav, and they will entangle them and confuse them. That's part of the achrayis of the rav. And the Lubavitcher Rabbeim, the Chabad Rabbeim, were incredibly careful to communicate to us Teiras Chabad in such a way that that kind of confusion should not develop and happen. And it's consistent with the point that we're making, that there's in Avoidas Hashem, not in Torah, but in Avoidas Hashem, you need one path, not many paths. Thank you.